Welcome to the Archivematica 1.8 screencast. In this screencast, I'll show you some new features in Archivematica's user interface, also known as a web-based dashboard. Updates to the user interface include a new Approve Automatically checkbox in the Transfer tab, settings providing improved thumbnail generation management during normalization, and new buttons enabling you to download and to reset any processing configuration. Before we begin, thank yous all around to our sponsors for these updates, JISC and Columbia University Library. Let's take a look at the first update on the dashboard, and it's a new automatic transfer approval checkbox. I've just started Archivematica and clicked Transfer on the dashboard. Up at the top, you'll see the Approve Automatically checkbox. By default, this box is ticked. Users can uncheck the box and approve their transfers manually if desired. Disabling this setting means that a transfer will only proceed after it receives user input at the Approve Transfer decision point. Until then, users can review their transfer directly from wherever it's stored. So let's run a quick demo here. I'll give the transfer a name. And I'll leave the accession number and access system ID edit fields blank. You can populate them with whatever is required by your institution's policies. Add some sample files. And for this demonstration, I'll disable Approve Automatically and then start the transfer. So we'll give it a minute or two. Okay. So you'll see the transfer listed below. And looks like we've come to a decision point. We have the option now either to approve the transfer or reject the transfer. Now, let's kick off another transfer, this time with the Approve Automatically checkbox enabled. So, I'll give it a name and call this one Automatic Approval. Oops. Add some files there and then click Start Transfer. So once this new transfer pops up, okay, it's showing up in the transfers list. You'll see the contrast between the two jobs. So in the first one that I named Demo 2. We unticked or disabled Approve Automatically, and so the first decision point is asking us whether or not we want to approve or reject the transfer. And in my latest transfer, the one where I enabled Approve Automatically, we've skipped the Approved Transfer microservice and just headed straight to the assigned file UUIDs and checksums. And so the first decision point then is asking us about assigning UUIDs to directories rather than to approve the transfer altogether. So there you have the approve automatically checkbox. Next, let's take a look at the processing configuration download and reset buttons. We're back on the dashboard and I've just clicked the administration tab. I'll go ahead and click processing configuration. In this view, you'll see all default and customized processing configurations listed. For each configuration, you'll also see the new download and reset buttons. Clicking download enables easy retrieval of your custom config files. In previous versions of Archivematica, config files can only be accessed via the command line. Now they're available for download with the click of a button. Clicking reset enables you to reset back to the default setting. A couple of key things to note when you're working in the processing configuration form. Remember that changes to the configuration form are written to a file called processingmcp.xml. When you start a transfer in the Archivematica dashboard, it automatically uses the default processingmcp.xml file. Once you've created a custom processing configuration, you can download the XML file by clicking on Download, as I mentioned previously. Then you can rename this file processingmcp.xml and place it in the root directory of the transfer. Archivematica then will use the included file to make processing decisions rather than the default configuration file. Documentation for creating and configuring a custom configuration has also been updated. You can find all user documentation and other helpful resources on archivematica.org. Let's take a look at the generate thumbnail settings now. So we're back in the administration tab and looking at the processing configuration view. For demonstration purposes, I'll just go ahead and click edit for one of our custom configs. And if you scroll down, you'll find the new generate thumbnail settings. So let's take a closer look at the generate thumbnail options. And we have four options currently to choose from, and they include none, which means the user is prompted for a decision, no, means that thumbnails will not be generated, and of course, yes, thumbnails will be generated according to the format rules in the FPR. Formats which do not have a rule will have a default thumbnail generated. For example, if you had a text file, you might see a gray document icon. And lastly, the fourth option in generate thumbnails is yes without default. So what that means is thumbnails will be produced for any format, which has a normalize for thumbnails rule in the FPR. Formats which don't have a rule will not have a thumbnail generated. Okay, so those are all the UI changes in Archivematica 1.8. There's lots more to talk about in this release, so stay tuned for more screencasts. For a comprehensive list of all the new features and ongoing development, check out the release notes and other resources on archivematica.org and head to the wiki.